Welcome to Type 2 Diabetes number 7. Today I'm going to tell you why I hate sugar as an endocrinologist. Now, I had an important question from a subscriber here, and he basically wants to know if you can eat sugar if you have type 2 diabetes or sweet stuff. Now, there are thousands of studies on sugar, and sugar can increase your risk of diabetes, type 2 diabetes, can increase your risk of high blood pressure, can increase your risk of cancer, can increase your risk of heart disease, and a lot of other stuff. Well, you might say, oh, thank God I don't eat sugar. But really, do you know how much sugar you are eating without knowing? How much sugar is added in the things that you eat? You know, in some countries that, for safety reasons, I will not mention the names, they're eating, on average, 17 teaspoons of added sugar every single day. Now, before you start blaming the food industry for adding sugar to everything, you know that they have to do that. Sugar is the best thing that they can add to food to keep you coming back and buying the food. They need something addictive. They're destroying our generation, but you have to give them credit for making billions of dollars at the cost of your health. Now, as an endocrinologist, this is the real reason why I don't like sugar. If you eat a lot of sugar, you will be in one of these situations. The first one is where you have insulin resistance, but your beta cells are still going to the gym. Not literally, but they're still strong enough to produce enough insulin to compensate for all the sugar that you're putting in your body. But the insulin coming from the beta cells will help this sugar get into different cells in your body. And they will be stored as glycogen or fat. And you will gain weight. The sugar will not stay high in your body, but you are gaining weight. That's before we even diagnose you with type 2 diabetes. Now, if you are a professional athlete, you will not gain this weight because most of the sugar will be stored as glycogen. And when you go do sports, when you go play football or something else, you will use that glycogen. But if you have type 2 diabetes or pre-diabetes, I am 500% sure that you are not a professional athlete. You're not any athlete. Now, let's say that you have passed this stage and you didn't do anything about it. You are here, where you still have some insulin resistance, but your beta cells are already weak, or some of them are dead, and you cannot produce enough insulin to compensate for all the sugar that you are putting in your body. Now, you will not gain more weight because you don't have enough insulin, but the sugar will stay in your body. And if you're here, where you finally managed to destroy all your beta cells, or some of them are disabled or something like that, at this stage, you put a lot of sugar in your blood, raises your blood sugar, but there's no enough insulin coming from the beta cells. You will probably lose weight, because if you don't have insulin, you will lose weight. But the sugar will stay in your blood for a long time. And this can cause all kinds of complications. So it doesn't make sense for you to eat sugar if you have type 2 diabetes. Because every time glucose gets in, glucose forces beta cells to release insulin. If they have insulin, you'll gain weight. If they don't have, the sugar will stay in your blood. So you cannot win. And if you are here, and let's say you're taking medications, you're taking insulin, or some medications like sulfonylurea, that will make the beta cell squeeze that last amount of insulin, you will go back to here, where you have enough insulin because you're taking them, but you will gain weight. And that's why insulin and those medications that force your beta cells to release the last amount of insulin they have will never be the first line of therapy for type 2 diabetes. Oh, there is one situation where sugar is good. If you are here and you take too much insulin, and later you have hypoglycemia, that means your blood sugar goes too low. In that situation, if you have some sugar nearby, it will save your life. So that's why normally patients that are on insulin walk with sugar in their pocket, because it might be useful in this situation. But anywhere else, sugar is bad. Well, I'll stop here and give this video a thumbs up so that more people can see it. And subscribe here and allow this notification somewhere here. And don't forget to share the video with all your sugar lovers, your lovers of. And don't forget to share this video with all your sugar loving friends, the ones that share with everyone. Have a blessed week. Bye.